So we've got our two sets of resistors here, and we've got our legend here to show us which is which. The important thing to note when you're doing your zone doubling is the 3Ks, the ones with orange, are going to go for the low side of the zone, or the lower number of the zone, and the other ones for the higher number. So the way you do zone doubling, you're going to take two different zones and land them on one set of terminals, so ground and Z2. And the way it works is your zone 2 will also be your zone 10. And your different value resistor will let you know which device is actually going off. So I'm going to take one of my 3K resistors. Since we're doing our zone 2, I'm going to go with the lower value resistor. I'm going to take my little connector piece, and we're going to go the low side of the zone connected to the resistor. Clamp it down. So we've got our connection. And always resistor to the low side of the zone, or label GND here. And then our high side is going to go to Z2. So we've got our zone 2 connected, ready to do zone 3, which on our list was back windows. So we've got our zone 3. I'm going to cut off our old resistor. Connect to our smaller 3K resistor. To our low side. Got our connector splice matching our black wire, or our low side of the zone, to the resistor. Clamp it down. And we're going to connect this to zone 3. We can clean these wires up and hold on to our tools. So we're going to land on zone 3. Zone 3 actually shares a common or a low side with zone 4. So we have a GND that we're going to land our resistor. And then our high side of our zone. We're going to connect to zone 3. And we've got zone 3 connected. Zone 4 is our French doors. Let's try to find that one. Here we go. And again, snipping off our old resistor. Got to strip our wire a little bit. with it stripped, make our connector to our resistor. Again, the smaller 3K value resistor connected to our low side of the zone or our black wire. We connect this here, crimp it down. Makes our connection nice and tight. And we're gonna land this to zone 4. Feed it up and under. And since zone 4 is a shared common with zone 3, we're gonna use the same terminal that we have zone 3 connected on. Feed the wire up and in. Let's see here. There we go. We got both our commons for zone 3 and zone 4. And then we're landing zone 4 to the screw terminal labeled Z4. Nice and tight, good to go. Zone 5 is our sliding door. And we actually had a sliding door upstairs and a sliding door downstairs. Our old panel did not designate one from the other with their zone descriptions. So we want to make sure this is our zone 9 sliding door. That's not the one we want. We want our downstairs slider, which is zone 5, which is right here. It's a double slider, so there's two loops in series, and here we go. We're going to snip off our old resistor. And strip our wire. This wire does not want to strip very well. Let's see if we can get this sheath off. Okay. Take our 3K resistor. Quickly using up our 8 here. Again, low side with the resistor. Crimp it down. Got our connection, and we've got our two sides of the door connected in series here. We're going to put our zone 5 low side to GND in between zone 5, zone 6. It's going to share a common just like 3 and 4 did. We're going to take our zone 5, land it on the terminal labeled Z5. And good to go on zone 5. All right, zone 6, we have back bathroom. This is our downstairs bathroom door leading out to the outside. They happen to have run, interestingly enough, their resistor on their red wire for their old job, which really doesn't matter. The color is not important. It's more important to have the resistor on the proper terminal that you're landing it to. So we're just going to strip off this red sheath here. And to keep things consistent, we're going to use the black side with our 3K resistor. We have not used any of our high zones yet. We're still on our bottom half of our zone doubling. Not until we get up to zone 10. Will we start into the zone doubling? So we've got our black and our resistor. Press down, nice and tight. I'm gonna feed this through this mess of wires, and we've got our zone 6. So again, we're sharing a common here with zone 5. So you'll have two resistors landed under there, just like we did with 3 and 4. 5 and 6 share a common. Wire it in, and then zone 6. Zone 6 is done. All right. Zone 7. And we have, actually, that last one, can't read my writing, that was the back bedroom. So now we're going to do our bathroom downstairs, or bathroom bottom. Zone 7. Take it back. I was right the original time. That was our bathroom. So now we have our zone 7, which is our downstairs bedroom. They've gone back to using the resistor on the black side. Snip off their old resistor. Strip the wire. Get our connector to our resistor, down to our last two resistors here for our low 3K, bottom half of our zone doubling. Slide in the black wire with the resistor. Crimp down. Nice tight connection. And we're going to land for zone 7. First, fish this through. And we're going to go Z7 is going to get our high wire, our red wire. And then our GND, or rather our low side, is going to go to our GND, which is another shared terminal, zone 8, and we've got zone 7. Okay. With zone 7 up, we're left with zone 8, which is our last bottom half one, and that's our garage door. See if we can locate that one. I think it's this one right here, zone 8, yep. Cut off our resistor. Splice our wire. Connect our resistor to our low side, and this is our last 3K resistor. All the rest of our resistors, we're going to use the 6.2s for our top half of our zone doubling. So we're essentially halfway there. Get this connected in. Crimp down and connected. Sharing our ground with our previous zone 7. Feed this up and under, and we're going to land our resistor. Share it along with that one. Nice and tight. And then zone 8. Go into there. So now we've got our zones 1 through 8, and we are left with 6 more zones.